organization. Welcome, Ruchi. You want to say hi?
Thank you very much, Tashmeet, for such a warm welcome, beautiful introduction. Thank you very much. I'm so happy to be here and be amongst all these fantastic people. Thank you very much.
The pleasure is all ours, and we're looking forward to a wonderful, wonderful panel discussion ahead. We have a second panelist, Mr. Sandeep Verma. He is a mythologist, a storyteller, and an author. A wonderful storyteller at that. Sandeep studied narrative environment design from Central St. Martin's College of Art and Design, London. He has worked in leadership roles in the advertising industry with companies like Ogilvy and Gray in the past. His passion to revive Indian mythology and stories led him to create these amazing programs that he leads across different countries. And he is also one of the co-founders of Cobalt Blue Foundation. Welcome, Sandeep. Would you like to say hello?
Thank you, Tashmeet. And thank you, everybody, for having me here on this talk show today. And I look forward to a wonderful session. Thank you.
You're welcome. And our handsome man, Harbinder, Herbie as I call him, is a personal brand strategist who helps individuals open doors to their untapped possibilities. He works closely with business owners as well as senior working professionals. After spending many, many years in the corporate world, much like Sandeep, myself, Harbinder turned to entrepreneurship. He has worked with the Times of India Group, RT Inc., Bune Gormo and Google. At Google, he started their business development operations in India. Amazing. As well as spearheaded the launch of YouTube in India. He took to entrepreneurship and founded a health portal followed by consulting projects with Bloomberg and Pearl Academy. In 2017, he kickstarted a rural healthcare screening project in South Africa and then launched Health FAQ, which led him to introspect and research the art of personal branding. And has since advised the senior professionals in India and overseas. And let me tell you, by my own personal experience, he is extraordinary at that. So welcome, Harbinder. Harbinder, would you
Thank
like
you
to
so unmute yourself? It is an honor to have this kind of... Can you hear me?
Yes, now yes.
Yeah, thank you so much, Tashmeet. That was a very generous introduction. And it's an honor for me to be here and discuss how personal branding and storytelling with my colleagues Ruchi and Sandeep can help the artists. So thank you for having me here.
I'm a TV guy today and I have to tell good stories. So yes, it was to happen. So welcome all of you. Welcome Harbinder, Ruchi and Sandeep. But we'll start the evening with our very, very passionate and beautiful lady, Ruchi Roo. Ruchi, let me start today's discussion with you. My first question to you is, can you tell me how important it is for an artist to have a personal brand in today's world? And how to tell your story that is true and be an inspiration, a story that connects with communities around us? Because only when they connect, is when they come back to us again and again and again. Ruchi.
Okay, so Rashmeet, I feel that personal branding or telling your story is probably the one of the most important things anybody, artist or non-artist, must do. Because if you would not tell your story, someone else will. So it's better you narrate your own true, authentic story. The second thing, I always feel that you should be authentic. Because you cannot fake for too long. Being authentic and telling your story the way it is happening to you is the most beautiful way of documenting your journey and showing people and connecting people to the truest emotions. Right now, I'm mentoring a few artists and non-artists into creating their personal brands. And the only thing that I truly tell them is be yourself. Tell people that you are who you are. Do not fake it, because you cannot fake it for too long, you know? Sure. And I think a lot of people here will agree with me that it is difficult to fake for too long.
Yeah, beautifully said. You are who you are. And it's very, very difficult to be someone else, because in times it all opens up. So very beautifully put up. Sandeep, would you like to say something more on that?
I think, you know, it's very important to have your story curated very well yourself. As Yuchi said, that if you don't tell your story, somebody else will tell it. And I truly believe that most of the artists in India or creative professionals, you know, they rely a lot about their work. A lot of people talk about their work, but I think people really want to know who they are behind the work, what is their life story, what inspires them, what motivates them, and that will become much more connecting with the audience in the art world and, you know, general public at large. So having a paying attention to your story, curating it very well is very, very important.
Thanks, Sandeep. Curating your story and paying attention to it in this very busy world today, while we are living in this concrete jungle, it's very easy to actually forget your own story and forget your own self while we are actually fighting for our daily bread and fighting for our families. But it becomes then very, very important, because especially in the with the advent of social media today, with the advent of the new world that's coming in, post-COVID world, we have the same wide market, and we have a lot of artists also competing for the, or the galleries competing for the same wide market. So with that context, Harbinder, what do you think, being authentic and being true to yourself and being really being able to tell that story out there? Because it's not, in my own experience, it's not art that sells, it's the story that sells. So how important do you think is being authentic and being your own self while you're creating a story for the social media, for the websites, and is that enough?
So, Dashmeet, you know, there are two very interesting things, especially when you come to the field of art. Now, if you look at some of the most successful artists in the long term, they have been true and authentic to the art that they are doing, right? The investors are investing in that same art with a very different perspective, right? But how does the art, so the artist is connected to the art, the investor is connected to that same piece of art, but how does the artist connect with the investor? You know, that's a very big gap which nobody is trying to, not many artists have been able to do it while, so that is the reason you have these struggling years, and only when they become popular do they get the story out. So I think the missing link is the story part of it, that, you know, what is it that people understand about the artist and his purpose behind the art that he's creating. So that's one. Now, coming on to the social media and digital media, I think all these medium, all this media is just the tools to get your story out. You know, whether it is social media, whether it is online marketing, SEO, or branding. But they are not the brand in itself. The story is the brand, because that brings the purpose, the why behind the art, as well as the emotional connect. I mean, we've seen that, you know, when people buy anything,
right?
You know, when people buy anything, they first have an emotional connect with whatever they are buying, even when it's come to clothes, the food that they eat, or the art that they are buying. It's only when they have that emotional connect do they start rationalizing it using their brains. Right. So then they figure out that, you know, okay, yes, this is a good piece of investment, or I think that this piece of art is great and everything. So it's the emotional connect that comes in first, and then the rationalization follows it. So I think when the emotional connect becomes the primary thing, the storytelling becomes imperative as a piece of success, or the connect that an artist must have with the market.
Superb, very well said. You mentioned about Harbinder, there have been artists, masters across India, there've been masters across the Western world, talking of Picasso, talking of Van Gogh, talking of M.F. Hossain, Raza Saheb. All of these artists have been there, and I feel somewhere they were brand unto themselves, and directly or indirectly, they were able to tell that story. Sandeep, would you like to say something about how how these progressive masters have created the brand equity for themselves?
See, I always tell people that it's been such a long time, we haven't heard a moving story of an artist in a long time in India. I think the last major story that general public know of any artist, obviously Hussain became very popular for whatever his antics and his paintings of Bollywood celebrities, and you know, he could work with the media very well. But it's been quite a long time, you know, isn't it, Dasmeet? We haven't heard of a artist story that's going mainstream or a lot of people talking about, right? But we know that we are constantly bombarded with the stories from Europe and from Western world about there's a reinvention of Van Gogh so many times in so many mediums. They even launched a movie made of, you know, somebody painted each frame in Van Gogh style, and that was launched a few years back. So they're constantly, reinventing the stories of Van Gogh, and there are other artists which are there, like Picasso. People know about their characters, their stories. In India, the stories of our artist is also as powerful,
right?
Also as wonderful as these stories. Story of Hussain is in no way less tragic than the story of Van Gogh. Story of Raza itself can work as a wonderful story for our times today. A Muslim painter getting inspiration from Indian Sakya philosophy of Upanishads, which then goes into the Sakta clan, which is the tantric ways, and then comes out with these mandalas and paints them as a reflection of his own soul.
Right.
How beautiful is that story to be told,
absolutely,
right? But how many people know about it? And even if people know about it, how many people are really curating it and telling it to their young artists and children to inspire them? So I think it's quite a shame that being a country of storytellers and where everything is built on stories, we are not able to really curate the stories of the art story of India. Forget about taking it to the world, but also we should be able to tell these stories, and people should pick these stories, find meaning in them and tell people. So that brings me to the very important point. The first point is that if you are an artist, and you want to market yourself in this today's current digital social space, you must put a meaning to your story, right? You just can't say, I was born in a village, I struggled, I didn't have money to buy painting, and I painted, right? That could be a story, but what is the meaning of your story? Why should somebody invest their time in listening to your story? So when you make your story, make sure you attach a meaning to your story that people can take back home. You know, that's very important. So there's a meaning in every story of artists. There's a meaning in Hussain's story. There's a meaning in Van Gogh's story. There's a meaning in Picasso's story. So trying to find out that meaning in your own story, and then stick to it and constantly let it out in public so that people understand why they should listen to your story.
Wonderful.
Can I just add here, Sandeep, you brought out a very beautiful thing about the meaning that the storytelling provides,
right?
You know, I mean, we all human beings anyways have this beautiful inherent art, which has been God gifted, that we give meaning to everything that we see and we give meaning to everything that we hear. So unless the artist or anyone else for that matter, unless they consciously start telling this story with the meaning that they want to be known in their target audience, if they don't consciously do that, people will anyway start giving meaning to their own meaning or their own interpretation to the person's story, right?
Right.
So it is so important for anyone to consciously control the story that they want the world to hear about them.
Right. Okay, gentlemen, I think I would like to give a perspective here, you know, because being a female artist, a young female artist, and being a person who was pretty outgoing, who studied in UK, you know, I came back and I was like all dazzling and I was like making art and I was going to the art parties and, you know, pretty much talk of the town. And then suddenly a gentleman comes to me, a lady comes to me and she's pretty aged and seasoned. I respect her a lot. And she's like, beta, drink ko cover kar lo. Drink ki picture nahi aani chahiye. And I was like, acha aunty, kar leti hu. And then, you know, I posted a picture on Facebook and she's like, beta, sari pictures delete kar do. Jitni bhi hai, apne na UK wale time ki. Hata do unko Facebook se, it will create a better brand image. Then I listened to them and I was listening to everybody because I was so new to the art world and I wanted to explore it, you know. But then I realized one day, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. What matters is how amazing my art is, how amazingly I'm able to sell and tell my story on the spot. How I dazzle, personally dazzle people. That is important. People don't care what I'm eating, what I'm drinking, what I'm wearing, how I'm partying. People don't care about it. If your work is not good, it's not going to sell. You are not going to sell if your work is not good. End of story. You can do whatever you like. If you're not authentic, you're not being yourself, you're not spending time, quality time, creating quality artwork, your work will never reach its zenith. That's all I know about being an artist brand. And it's a very personal story because, you know, I've gone through it.
So you guys can imagine. On that note, Ruchi, on that note, yeah, Sandeep. On that note, Ruchi, you know, you talked about artist and the brand.
Yeah. So
is the artist and the brand the same? Like you mentioned, you can't be a person, party person to show you are a serious artist. So like, what do you think? The brand and the artist, are they the same?
It is the same. You know, Dashmi, that's what I'm trying to tell you, that you cannot curate. You can curate it to a certain point, but after a while, you will start losing that battle of curation because how much can you curate? Idea here is to show the authentic self, and trust me, your authentic story is the most interesting story. No matter what you try to be, I can pretend to be someone else. I can pretend to be this sari bindi artist, but how long can I pull it? You know, yeah. I mean, there is a limit for me to pull that thing, you know, yeah. How much will I pretend? Ultimately my truth will come out. So I think from the day one, try to read, try to be interesting, invest in your work, and that will make your story interesting. If your work is not speaking for you, neither your story, nor your artwork, nor your Instagram, nothing will speak for you. So I think invest in yourself, invest in your brain, invest in growing, you know, and show that authentic self. I mean, I think it's beautiful, you know, for people to see the authentic you. People want to see it. I mean, I am I just tell people who I am. I don't really care what they think or, you know, I mean, I've obviously come a long way, but even as a young artist, I'd never cared what people thought of me, you know, so yeah.
Super. Thanks for that. Sandeep, you wanted to add something, yeah?
Yeah, I just wanted to add something to that is that all that we are talking about here right now about telling a story and all that is for people who are artists, who are authentic, who are already doing great work, whose work is obviously honest and things like that, right? It's about if all the 100 great artists which are there right now and who have been here already, right? Their art is great. Right, Avinash Chandra is as great as other members of a progressive group of artists in India. And my point is that why do we know about some artists more and we don't know about other artists at all? Right? Why some artists who have great work, who are honest, still live in oblivion, and some artists whom we know all about? Why Hussain sells more than other artists whose story you don't know at all? Right? First,
right.
Curation doesn't mean manipulation. Okay, it does not mean that you change yourself to fit into a story. No. What I am talking about as a personal brand is that you just need to be a storyteller. You just need to know how to tell a story. Okay, tell your authentic story. Show your authentic rebel character. If you are rebellious, if you don't fit into the society, that's who you are.
Yeah.
So be it, right? Do not need to change yourself. You don't need to cover your drink glass. You don't need to change pictures on Facebook and stuff like that. That's your story. that what else people know you about beyond that, right? So that's those things need to be told to people, you know. And, if you talk about people don't care what you wear, what you don't wear, but once you become an artist of that level, people do care about what you wear, because you become an icon, right? You all know that. What is the t-shirt of Picasso, right? You know, is that striped? Yeah. You know, yes. The mustache of Salvatore Dali, right? You know Van Gogh's style of clothing, his choice of sunflowers, right? So then that's why you connect with them, because you know the person behind the painting, right? Absolutely. And that's so authentic. Van Gogh never tried to show himself as a stable rich guy, but his story was told by others later on, so he did not probably have to over it. But Picasso, Dali, even Andy Warhol, right? They all were great storytellers, right? They told their stories about who they are, but they told it. What I'm saying is that the artists in India, right, who stay away from these, who stay away from becoming a storyteller, or who stay away from not talking too much about their story and things like that, the outcome of that directly is that you lose in terms of connecting with people. That's about it.
Yeah.
So, Sandeep,
I tend to completely agree with him, because you know what happens is that, of course, I agree with Ruchi as well, because when I do personal branding for my clients, I mean, it's a complete no-no. We don't even sign up with anyone who's not willing to be authentic. But at the same time, what happens is you are doing a disservice to yourself if you are not able to bring your art out to the world and explain it to the world, the reach that is there. Because unless you get the visibility and be known for what you stand for, I mean, you know, you're doing disservice to the work that you are doing. So yeah. I totally agree with you, Sandeep, that, you know, we need to come out and tell the story to the world, so that, you know, it's not that you want to be known only when you're gone, but you want to be known when you can actually make a difference.
Yeah, especially in today's world when we have social media with us, I think the world has shrunk, right? And if you are able to tell that story powerfully, people will connect with you. As I keep saying, if you connect with art, art will connect back with you. People connect with the art. People connect with the story of the art. They don't connect with the... So they may connect with you as an artist or as a human being as well, because when they see your internal story of your family, of your life, how this guy is living, it's surprising. People intrigue. People want to know you more. So when you start talking about that, it's amazing. And when you be authentic about it, it's really, really... It really works. I think the story of Art Circle International, for example, was one such story. We had three human beings, and all three suffering at one point in time because the lockdowns happened, galleries are closed down. I said, what is the story? I said, it's a story of togetherness here. It's a story of intent. It's a story of positivity. It's a story of coming together, right? It's a story of collaboration, real collaboration, where we're trying to, the intent is to bring everyone together. And we were surprised how people from 10 different nations joined us. Right. So I've been in the art industry for the last 9 years. I've been in the corporate industry for another 18 years. But this became like so easy for us, where people were actually, the community was actually connecting to us, rather than we chasing the community at any point in time, be it the artists, be it galleries, be it curators, be it art framers, the entire community of artists. And it was amazing. So having said that, and what I heard of Harbinder and Sandeep right now, Harbinder, you know, I feel, as an artist, you're as good as what you do. Sometimes your expression is all about just limited to painting on that canvas, or creating something through mud into a sculpture. Okay, so you're as good as that expression creating into the canvas. So does it become important then to hire a professional agency, a personal brand developer, or a storyteller to help you really rediscover your own self? Because you may be absolutely great at expressing your own self, what you see out in the world, and expressing it in your own style into the canvas. But when you come to talk about it or telling it on the paper, you may not be as good. So how important is it to have a brand strategist? How important is it to be able to get in touch with a storyteller who can help you connect with your own self and tell the story to the outer world.
So, you know, Dashmeet, in my personal opinion, I think it happens in phases. So one is that we are all human beings and we are dealing with human beings, right? So the person that you do personal branding of is as human as a person whom you're trying to target, right? And these are all very subjective areas. First is many a times we start with the objective of where we want to be without even trying to know ourselves. So I have a process of personal branding where I start with introspection. We actually spend a lot of time to understand the person right from there. Is what I believe is, if you are, and your value systems will show in everything that you do, whether you do it professionally or in personal life, your value systems and belief systems will very clearly start showing there, right? So that is a time when you need a little bit of help in terms of understanding who you really are and what your how you align to the vision that you have for yourself, and how will you target to the how you would create a reach to your target audience. But beyond that, there is nobody who can actually execute a personal branding for you the better than what you can do for yourself, right? Because like I said earlier, that social media and digital media are all one of the tools that are there to help you reach out to the world. But personal branding is beyond that. Personal branding happens every moment and every place where you are present. The fact that I'm here on a webinar, people who are listening to me and listening to all of us are creating opinions in their mind about us, right? Or when we go meet anyone, how we conduct ourselves will create an opinion in the minds of people who are around us, who are observing us, right? So it is a huge responsibility on the person to do the personal branding for himself or herself. But then later, as and when the journey grows, you get busier. And again, as human beings, you will always have distractions in your life. There'll be circumstances that will change. There'll be a sudden lockdown, and that could either give you a peaceful life, or you get ejected because you're not making money, your business is going down. So you'll go through these phases and they will affect you. What happens is that you lose on the consistency of whatever you are doing. So these distractions actually pull you down. And that is a time when you need consistency in the frequency of your messaging, in the underlying message that you're trying to bring to the people around you, in terms of the objective that you're trying to achieve, so that you don't move away from the path or the journey that you have chosen for yourself. So that is a time when you can probably have an agency. But there is no clear definitive answer for it. But I feel that you have to definitely do personal branding for yourself. But somewhere down the journey, you might need a professional to come in on board to ensure that you are doing a consistent personal branding. You're not getting distracted and you are aligning yourself to the objective. You're aligning yourself to the underlying messaging, and that is not getting diluted.
Right.
That's my take on it.
Sure. So I see three logos on the screens. I see your beautiful caricature that I almost feel that he's going to talk to me any point in time and is going to walk. And I see a beautiful cobalt blue logo, right? And I see the cobalt blue itself is very intriguing to me. You know, what does cobalt blue mean, and why would somebody want to name an organization cobalt blue? And what is the depth of that message? How beautifully somebody has actually encapsulated that this is what I stand for. And Sandeep, would you like to say something about that?
Well, you know, we were Cobalt Blue name came into being there's a thought behind that, right? So the thought is that the ink of the pen that we use to write a story, the color of that is exactly the shade of cobalt blue. And right. When you look at Earth from space, the Earth's color is also cobalt blue. So I like that analogy, and I thought this is a beautiful name and color also to use, because from the micro all the way to the color of the pen ink, all the way to the macros, which is the planet Earth, it's just all cobalt blue. So that's why we thought of the name Cobalt Blue. It was a name given to an agency at the beginning that works in the areas of brand storytelling, and then Cobalt Blue Foundation continued from that, and so we keep that. Interestingly, the color of our logo is actually orange, which is Cobalt Blue. So we like that contrast also. That shows our personality, especially Ruchi's personality. She's very talkative. So Cobalt Blue is a name, and color is orange. So that's the thing.
So you have beautifully, you talked about, we all of us talked about how important it is to understand or maybe form a style, but at the same time, being able to understand your own self, what is going on inside of you, and bring that story out, right? So I think Cobalt Blue being at the foundation, that I think you've beautifully brought that story out. Do you think artists, it is very important for them to bring their own personal story out apart from their style? So, and how should they do it? Because they're most of the time just producing works of art, right? They're just in that competitive world, okay, this person has created these many works or he's doing these many shows. I should be doing more and more and more. And that what is happening in the world is we are always running after more than the actually quality of life and quality of connection with the community out there, be it a collector, be it a museum. So would you, Ruchi, would you want to say something about that? How would you delve into your own self? How do you tell your own story?
See, I think for me, it's very easy. Again, I will document the way things happen to me. You know, I would not go too haywire. You know, I would document even a dot. If I create a dot, I would like to post it and show it that it is my authentic dot, you know. And obviously, you know, I mean, in the digital space, and I'm talking about now because we cannot go to each other's studios. You know, earlier we used to have a lot of studio hopping. We would invite people to come into our spaces, experience our work. But now, because, you know, it is definitely not possible, I think it's a great idea to bring people to your studio, to your spaces, and show them your work in progress. It's extremely important for artists to do that, you know, because it connects people more to the process, and process itself is a story, you know. Dashmeet, you know it, you're a very hands-on artist, and you work with, you know, light, you work with mud, and I know the elements that you work with, and I know once I know those stories, I emotionally connect with the message that you're giving, and I connect with your artwork. So it's very important for an artist, while he's telling his story and while he's curating his story, to document his work in progress also, because it kind of tells another very important aspect of that story.
Beautiful. Harbinder, you want to add something to that? Especially in context she talked about social media also, like how important is it to one being able to create the story, and then the importance of social media in creating that brand, especially in present context, because maybe it's very slightly difficult today to bring somebody inside the studio for the current situation that we have. Yes, Zoom has made it possible. We all are sitting in, like Shankar is sitting in Pune right now, Siley is in Mumbai, and we all are in different parts of Delhi NCR. So yes, we are inside each other's spaces, but then how would you make it? Is social media extremely important in that present context?
See, I'll tell you what. So I would not restrict to just social media per se, Dashmeet. I mean, I would like to use a little larger term, the technology and the digital technology. I mean, look at what Art Circle has done. You know, we have kind of opened up the reach of the art across geographies. You know, we have tried to do something which is beyond what was imaginable a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Right? The kind of connect that we have. What has happened is social media has done two things for us, and it is not just for the field of art, but for the world anyways. One, it has created an easier medium to manage. I mean, we have the power in our hands on this mobile, right? Right from taking a picture to shooting a video to sharing it with the world, we have it. I mean, it can be done at in a jiffy in less than, a minute. So it's become very, very easy. Second thing that it has done is it has created a reach beyond what we could imagine.
Right.
Right. So with the ease and the reach, I think it is a no-brainer for anybody to use this as a media to reach out to the world. Now, when it comes to aligning it with storytelling, you know, the media, the nature of media is such that it is a visual form today, and we can create movies which was otherwise restricted to only the top dollar advertising companies, right? So what are we doing? I mean, you know, we can express ourselves. I can sit down today, just talk to my phone and record it and express my inner self to the whole world, right? True. And when people can see me, when they can hear me talk, they will be able to relate to me. So I'm a more relatable product today, right? Because the moment I'm able to reach out and people are able to relate to me, I will have people who are of the similar nature who will come and build a community around me. So we build our own tribes, right? So as Ruchi mentioned about authenticity, we don't have to personify and try to be something that we are not or someone that we are not. We have enough people across the globe who will be similar to who we are. And then the like-minded people come together and you build a community who will see your perspective in how you do things, right?
Yeah.
So there is enough market for everyone to do whatever they feel like doing in a manner that they enjoy doing things, right? So you don't need to be someone else to go and sell your art or sell anything for that.
Beautifully said, I would say.
There'll be enough people who will be able to relate with it.
Yeah. I think the market is wide enough. The market is wide enough and you have to be just your own self, find your own self, be able to tell that story. I think that's what is coming out of this entire communication. And we have a picture of Mr. M.F. Hussain. Sahili, would you like to show that picture with the two pictures? And I would like to ask the audience, what is intriguing about that picture? So here the picture comes and I would want, yes. So this is a picture which I found very intriguing and would can somebody point out something which is unusual about the picture? This question is to all the attendees and participants. Do you think there is something intriguing? For me, there is the hint is there is something in the hand, and it's very different. It's a long brush.
Stick. Stick. Yeah, a long brush.
It's a long brush.
It looks like a stick, actually.
Yeah, it is not a stick. Yeah, so you would go out there into the communities with that long brush. And most of the times, you would see him. Thanks, Sheila. Yeah. And most of the times, if you see his feet, do you see something unusual? He's out there in the open. And it almost always got him into the limelight, that he would go into these public spaces, he would go into art shows, inaugurations, large public events, and he would always go bare feet. So which was, it almost became like his brand perspective or personality. And he beautifully carried it. I mean, he carried it and he talked about it, that I'm always feeling connected to the earth. I've come from here, wahi jaunga. I'm going to go there. And it just connects me with the planet Earth. And so I talk about a lot about environment or nature in my paintings. So you have to find something. Sandeep, would you want to add something to this?
I think you pointed out about him not wearing any shoes. That's also one point. Second, of course, the brush, which is there. But adding to the point where you were talking about, I would like you to actually show. Is there any other picture also after this that you wanted to show?
Yes, of himself, of him.
You should.
Shaili, can you please show other pictures? We have some Razas, and we have a Picasso, and we have a Van Gogh.
Okay. No, I just wanted you to finish that picture part.
Yeah, that was the... yes. This is something that we want to come as well to. So, yes.
So before we come to that, I think just to add to what Harbi said or Ruchi said earlier, they covered quite beautifully most of the part about personal branding for an artist, and Harbi talked, Ruchi talked about it's not limited to physical space, and the new situation is moving art to digital space, and Harbi shows his enthusiasm about the technology itself is much larger to be utilized and leveraged by the artist, and even personal branding by using video content, pictures, and things like that. And then you were asking, how do we do that, right? So then comes the point that, what do we do with those videos? What do we do in those images? What is the content that we put out there, right? Now, generally, from my experience with artists, there are two kind of artists, right? One where by default, the artist is anti-capitalist, right? He doesn't want to be part of the capitalist economy, right? He's withdrawn, he's detached from that, it's a very classic image of Jhola Chhap artist coming and doing stuff like that. Not in a, with all due respect, right? And also there are artists who then are absolutely running behind marketing and promoting themselves, right? Also, a lot of people look at it as a despicable act that you're an artist. You're not supposed to sell yourself, right? And that brings a very moral and ethical question for artists too, that should I even think about marketing? Is my work not good enough to sell itself? Or on the contrary, he would say, it's just a self-expression, right? I don't want to sell it. If somebody wants to buy it, they can put a value to it. I don't want to sell it, right? So these are the kind of, the basic problem lies in this thought here at the thing that where the image of an artist is such that he has to be a detached person from the society, from the money, from things, and then only he will be respected and valued. So the solution to that is that, don't look at your work as a product. Okay? Yeah. Don't look at your painting as a product. Your work is an honest expression of you, right? If you want to talk about something, if you want to tell a story or something, look at yourself. There's something about you that you have become an artist, right? You did not become an engineer or doctor or an entrepreneur. You have chosen this path. So there you have a story to tell. And what is the currency you take in exchange for that is that you will inspire more people to look at life the way you are looking. To take the path of being an artist, right? That is the reward you can look for if you don't want to look for money directly, right? Do it for that. Tell your story so that more people hear your story and they get inspired by you, right? That's the reward you need to focus on. So the end product here is not money. And I can tell you truly, the true artist doesn't really care about money by the end of it. It's a byproduct of his dedication of inventing a new concept, looking at life, coming out with looking at life from Cubist perspective or sense perspective. And then the society values that, right? Artists cannot go and say, look, I have created this. I'm asking 5 lakh rupees for this. You cannot put price on your thing. So what is the thing that you want? By doing all this activity of using technology and even we are having this session is that you have an obligation to society as an artist. You have an obligation to inspire people. You have an obligation, the gift that God has given you is to make people see the world from a new perspective that they don't see it yet. And that absolutely invaluable. There is no money that can buy that from you, and that's why you need to do that. So that's I think I wanted to put the context right for why an artist needs to tell his story, and that is reason. Second point, coming to the point, what is the content and what should be told and how you should tell your story? It's very simple. If life is a stage, you are a character in it, okay? And all you need to do is define your character very well. Know what is your character and live that character to the fullest. All the artists that you know of and that we know who have left a mark also have a unique style, visual personality that you can identify with. You know what is a Picasso, how he stands, you know Van Gogh, you know Hussein's, you just right now highlighted some of the point about him, right? These are some of the stories that we are talking about their characters, right? It's like when you read a story, you say, why did Krishna killed Kans, right? There's a story, there's a question you're asking about the character, you know? Why did Krishna ran away with Rukmani in mythology, for example, right? If he is a god, you are questioning a doubt you have about the character. So you build your character arc through this content, right? You build your character arc over the period of time and you live it, okay? You stay in the character, as they say in the movies, that for the entire duration of the movie, you are in the character. If you are a police inspector in a movie, you are a police inspector. You cannot become somebody else, right? Your morality, ethics, visually, everything like that. So as an artist, discover what is your true character, what is your true archetype, as I say, and make that as your story. Walk with it, live it, and people will find you and connect with you and even copy you in that sense as well. So be the character and tell your story, because the world needs your story.
So, can I add something, Dashmeet?
Yes, sure.
Yeah. It's very beautiful what Sandeep has brought out, that the life is a stage and you are a character in it, and you have to define your character so well. I'd like to add, so that you become identifiable. You know, there's a reason that you can identify a picture, an art of Van Gogh, and be able to say that, you know, this is Van Gogh's art. Or you can see a painting done by Hussein and you can identify it, you know, because they had their unique style in whatever they were doing. And they were able to communicate that style to make it identifiable by everyone around them in the ecosystem, right? So you could identify their art. So, you know, and if you look at the characteristic of how you do your personal branding, the things that you do are basically trying to differentiate and identify that uniqueness, right? Which is differentiating you from everyone else in the ecosystem. Second is very strongly stand by what you believe in or your unique style, right? Which is so, and after that, you know, there's a piece of you in everything that you create. So every piece of art that you do or create, there's a signature style that says that, you know, this is linked or this is connected with this particular artist.
Yeah,
I think that is probably one of the ways that you can succeed, you know, and do your branding well. You know, if you, I'm many a times in many platforms, I'm asked the difference between the corporate branding, the product branding, and the personal branding. If an entrepreneur, an artist, or any person does a personal branding for himself so that he stands for his uniqueness, his unique style, his unique way of doing things, and people believe in that particular uniqueness, then anything that you do will sell.
Agreed.
You get my point? So, you know, so that is the reason. I mean, you know, you have one entrepreneur who succeeded, and he has a reputation of creating successes. Next time he wants to do some other business, he gets investors because people will believe that, you know, anything that he does, he'll do well, right? Similarly, I mean, why do people invest so heavily in crores in certain pieces of art? Because they know that, you know, this can't go wrong. Even if you look at, movie making, why do certain stars command the price that they get paid? because there's a promise that is there that, you know, this guy, if he's acting in a movie, I will not go in for a loss. I may not make, may not be the top grosser, but I will not go in a loss. So I think, yeah, you know, at the end of the day, we are also doing this to sell. I mean, this is a profession. The artist, when he chooses this as a career, he's trying to convert his passion into a profession, right? He needs to make his money out of it. So, I mean, that is the reason probably he needs to become a brand which is identifiable, that the investors will pay money or invest in his piece of art. So I think, you know, the metrics of success when it comes to your own personal passion getting fulfilled versus your professional needs getting fulfilled, at the end of the day, need to match.
Sure. So thanks for that, Harvinder. I think you talked about just creating a brand name for artists in short sales. It does. It does. And we've seen it in all these 4 or 5 case studies that we discussed today. They lived their morality, they lived their ethics, they lived, they created their own styles, and they lived it. They were fearless. They went out all the way, living that and being authentic, being their own self. And eventually they became brand into themselves. A lot of them don't want to be called brands. That's another story. But then, yes, if you look at it from the commercial angle of it, they are brand into themselves. You will recognize the painting just by looking at it at the first glance. That's a Hossein, that's a Raza, that's a Picasso, or that's a... So that is very, very beautifully said. Being your own self. Ruchi, do you want to add any last tricks? Or do you think there is a little more than anything than social media, you know, networks of people, being at the right places at the right time, apart from those group shows or being seen across with the right artists in the right show? Sometimes artists are a little scared about, my artwork should not be here because there are artists at this level and I'm already here, or all of that. Do you think there are other forms where he can go out and tell his story to those communities? Are there more spaces like that? What else can he do apart from social media, apart from his website, apart from
I think you should educate yourself. I think you should look at some of the best people brands that have been built in India and abroad. Look at Mahatma Gandhi. He's probably the first brand ever built in India. This guy was, with all due respect, Mahatma Gandhi was the first brand in himself. You look at his shape, his glasses, you look at his face, the curve, you look at the dandi, you look at that dhoti, you look at that fabric, the piece of cloth, you know. Nehru, look at the branding, the solid branding of a red rose, that Nehru topi and the Nehru jacket. These icons are what you should be looking at, because these people found their own styles, you know. And they were authentic to their style and they lived it day in and day out, you know. It was not something that they did one off and stopped doing, you know, because they were so comfortable in their own self, in their own style, in their own way of talking, that when you are like that, I mean, I'm telling from every perspective, you know, be it an artist, a non-artist, because I address everybody here, of course the artist, but you need to understand yourself. Self-awareness is very important. Knowing yourself, like Sandeep said, understand your archetype, understand who you are, and then live it, you know. Live it, experiment with it day in and day out, you know. And that will, your personality, your art, everything will merge, and then you will come out to be an artist like Raza, you know, who lived his Bindu, you know, who had 100 stories around Bindus, you know. Entire life, Raza created Bindus, you know. And that's the beauty, you know. Horses of M.F. Hussain or Picasso's portraits, you know, all the disgruntled ex-girlfriends he painted, you know. And that's amazing, you know. So he became a style in himself and he lived that lifestyle. So I'm not saying they go out, break hearts. I'm not saying that. But what I'm saying is that if you want to truly develop a personal brand, live, understand yourself, become more aware of yourself, and then live it. Experiment with it, you know. And that's, I think, where I would like to, you know, leave everybody at to discuss, because I mean, obviously everybody can have a personal opinion here, but I think right now I'm talking more like an artist, you know, because I have been there and, you know, I am still, you know, an artist. So I think I'm giving out a very personal perspective here and not really talking like a storyteller.
I would say a very deep perspective, really.
Yeah. So,
you know, like Gandhiji talked about, now I really realize from another perspective, be the change that you wish to see in the world.
Yes.
And, you know, he was being, changing his own self,
yes,
rather than changing the world out there. With whatever Satyagraha he did, he said, I will do this. And no matter, no wonder then he's called the father of the nation today.
So once, Lashmit, right? I had a fortune of meeting Keshav Malik, and Keshav Malik was in one of my solo shows and he came to me. I was like, aap mujhe ek advice dijiye of becoming a good artist. He was like, when you are not painting, read and write. Yeah. I was like, how is it that going to help me? He's like, document your thoughts, find who you are, the true you. And that will come from your writing, your sketchbooks, and those will become your stories, you know? Yeah. And I took that to my heart and I started documenting myself. So if I was not painting, my paintings were getting made in those little books, you know. So I think that is one of the most fabulous advice I have ever got from an art critic or somebody. And later he said, if you're not going to put that painting on the wall, today you're not going to sell one painting. And tomorrow you have to take all these paintings and put on your wall. Would you be proud of it? I was like, yes, I'll be proud of it. He was like, then you have arrived. If you love your work so much that you will put it on your wall, then you have arrived. It doesn't matter if it sells or not. It will sell for sure, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah, no wonder my dad keeps telling me, you're making the house and turning the house into an art gallery now. Because a lot of my own works are in the...
No. You have to be proud of your work at the end of the day, them. You know.
Yes. Sometimes you love them so much that you don't want them to go. That's another question.
Yeah. Well, you know, sometimes you do, sometimes you keep, you know.
Thank you. On that note, now we're arriving at 7:18 right now. So on that note, I would want to cover one of the most important bit was you talked about being authentic to your own self, finding your own self. Guys, my request to everyone today here is once you start, as Ruchi pointed out very beautifully, start documenting your own self, connecting with your own self. And nobody else can really go out and do that for you. Of course, there are professionals out there who will help you only once you have done it for yourself. As they say, God connects with them who connects with them, like God helps those who help themselves.
Yeah.
I think a similar story here, right? Ruchi, if you only want to be that brand or that master and you want to grow your journey, really you will have to look inwards. Yeah. You'll have to connect with your own self and magic is ready to happen. It'll manifest in many ways beyond your imaginations. So thank you so much, Sandeep, Arbinder and Ruchi, for bringing out such wonderful communication out today, talking about storytelling. Sometimes we really don't think storytelling was all about while we were children. My grandmother, he was telling me the story, but see how beautifully they also did that. We have those amazing memories that we carry for our lives because they were great storytellers. They had less of media out there, but they were absolutely amazing storytellers and they connected with us heart to heart. And that's one of the wonderful examples. We talked about Gandhiji today. We talked about the Raza Sahib. We talked about Picasso. We talked about Van Gogh. We talked about some of us here. Great storytelling. And that's where magic happens. So with this, thank you so much. And I'd like to open up the floor for a Q&A if anyone would like to ask any questions. The next couple of minutes, we can open the floor for that. And also in the meantime, Saili could possibly show us one of the movies of the multiple artists that we possibly have while we get any questions.